Welcome students. Today we are going to understand non-finite forms of the verb. What are non-finite forms of verb? Actually, these are those verbs which are without any tenses. These are used independently in a sentence and they are not affected by the number and person of the subject. So, let us understand what are non-finite verbs. Firstly, you just understand that these are those verbs which are without any tenses. These are those forms of verbs. These are those forms of verbs which are without any tenses, which are without any tenses, they are not affected, by the number or person of the subject. By the number or person . So let us understand once more what are non-finite forms of the verb. These are those forms of the verb which are without any tenses. They are not affected by the number or person of the subject. Now, how many types of non-finite verbs are there? Types of non-finite form of verbs. There are three types of non-finite form of verbs. Number one, infinitive. First is infinitive. Second, participle. And the third is, second is participle and the third is gerund. We will have a small discussion what are these verbs and then we will understand infinitives in detail. So what are infinitives? These are the base form of a verb. What are these? These are actually the base form of the verb, used often with two and sometimes without two. So what are infinitives? These are base form. Base form are the root form of a verb, often used with two and sometimes also used without two. What are participles? These are verbal adjectives. And what are gerund? These are verbal nouns. What are gerunds? These are verbal nouns. So today in this class, we are going to understand infinitives. What are infinitives? What are their uses? So we will understand them in detail. And the rest, these two will be understood in other classes. So firstly, understand what are infinitives. As I told you that infinitives are of two types. Infinitive with two and infinitive without two. infinitives are categorized in two parts. First, simple infinitives, and second one, gerundial. They are broadly divided into categories, simple infinitives and gerundial infinitives. Both are used with to and without to. With to and without to. Now the infinitives which are used without to, these are called bare infinitives. The infinitives which are used, the infinitives which are used without to, these are called bare infinitives. Are called bare There are certain verbs which are followed by bare infinitives. There are certain verbs which are followed by bare infinitives. Verbs of generally, firstly, the verbs of perception. Some verbs take bare infinitives only after them. Which are these verbs? See, hear, watch, let, bid, need, help, dare. These are the verbs which will take bare infinitive after them, and there are two verbs here, need and dare. Need and dare will take bare infinitives only in negative sentences. Dare and need will take bare infinitives. These will take bare infinitives in negative sentences only. Dare and need will take bare infinitives in negative sentences only. For example, he dare not open the door. He need not go there. Let us have a quick revision of this space. There are two categories of infinitives, simple infinitive and gerundial infinitive. Both infinitives are used with to and without to. The infinitives which are used without to, these are called bare infinitives. And the verbs, some verbs actually take bare infinitives after them, or bare infinitives follow some verbs. Which are these verbs? See, hear, watch, let, bid, need, help, dare, etc. Here it is to be noted that need and dare, they will take bare infinitives only in the negative sentences. Okay? So, I hope you have understood infinitives till this part, till this stage. Let us understand the uses of simple infinitive. Uses of simple infinitive. These will be used as a noun basically, but as a noun also sometimes infinitive is used like a subject, sometimes as an object. So let us see how it is used in different ways. As a noun, and as a noun, how it is used as a subject. Example, to play cricket is quite interesting. To play cricket is quite interesting. To watch a movie was very nice. So here we can see infinitive to play and to watch are there. These are used as the subject of the sentence. Now infinitive can be used as the object of a sentence also. As an object. You need to obey your parents. You need to obey your parents. So here, you must go to pick your bag. You must go to pick. You must go to pick your bag. So here we can see that it is infinitive is used like an object. Sometimes the object is, sometimes infinitive is used also like a compliment. He is here to see us. He is here to see us. Ram was to meet his friend. Ram was to meet his friend. So here we can see that it is used as a complement to the verb. So let us quickly revise it. Here we are understanding uses of simple infinitive as a noun. To play cricket is quite interesting. Here to play is the subject and noun also. To watch, it is used as a subject as well as a noun, and here it is used as an object. You need to obey your parents. You must go to pick your bag. Here it is used as an object, and he is here to see us. Ram was to meet his friend. So here infinitive is used like a complement. So here like a complement. What is a complement? Complement is some word that is added to give a complete sense to the meaning of an incomplete sentence. Generally, it is used with the linking verb is that which are of the form be. Is, am, are, was, were, like that. So these are the forms of a be. Now let us see some more examples of complement of a verb. I made him. I made him run. He made him go. I made him run. He made him go. So here bare infinitives are used. We are using here bare infinitives for the complement to the verb made. What is the verb here? Made. And run is the infinitive, bare infinitive. Now, another use, they are governed by the preposition. They are governed by the preposition. He is about to go. He has no choice but to obey. He has no choice but to obey, and he is about to go. These are the examples. Here, infinitive is governed by the preposition. Now, sometimes what happens sometimes that they generally, what happens sometimes that they are used like case in apposition. When they are used as case in apposition, then we use the dummy subject it. It was not easy to say this. It is not good to help him. So here, to say this and to help him, these are case in apposition. To say this is a case in apposition with it. Similarly, to help him is a case in apposition with it. So these are the two examples. Here we have finished the usage of simple infinitive. So let us have a quick revision. This is another example how infinitive is used as a complement of a verb. I made him run. Here bare infinitives are used. He made him go. In both these examples, bare infinitives are used. They are governed by the preposition. He is about to go. Here about is the preposition. This is the preposition. He has no choice but to obey. So, but and about, these are the prepositions which are governing infinitives. And they are used also like case in apposition. It was not easy to say this. It is not good to help him. So, with this we end our class. I hope you have understood it. In the next class, we will understand the uses of gerundial infinitives. So thank you. You can go to the description box for finding the link for the old videos.